Welcome to Popular Cruising. You're watching our review of Carnival Cruise Line's Carnival Horizon. While the ship is very similar to the Carnival Vista, she also offers many new features as well. As for accommodations on board, we personally enjoyed a balcony stateroom, featuring pleasantly more subdued colors than previous Carnival ships, and a comfy bed that gets our teddy bear a stamp of approval. Plus a lovely private veranda. Back inside, storage is plentiful, but a tad plain in style. And always welcome at the desk are extra electrical outlets and USB charging ports. Bathrooms are also more chromatically soothing than before, and shower stalls are decently sized to maneuver in. Though for a newer ship, a fixed enclosure would be preferred over a flimsy curtain. Of course, other cabin choices include the Family Harbor Suite, ideal for parents and children traveling together. Complete with exclusive access to the Family Harbor Lounge, with its own dining area and soft serve machine. Internet and gaming stations, and other entertaining alcoves. Suites also include the Cloud9 Spa variety, and then there are the Havana cabins, including interior staterooms, cabana staterooms with outside views, and larger cabana suites. With wonderful outdoor amenities. Continuing the theme to all guests is the Havana Bar, with its central bandstand for live tropical music. And outside, Havana guests get exclusive access to the Havana Pool by day, which becomes available to all passengers at night. It all marvelously overlooks the back of the ship. Meanwhile, the Great Lanai Promenade wraps around the rest. For all sorts of alfresco dining and lounging opportunities. Not to mention simply observing the passing scenery and comfort. Just inside is the Ocean Plaza, hub of fun. Home of more live music as well as playful trivia sessions. where guests have an opportunity to win a coveted trophy of a ship on a stick. And for those without their own devices, just next door is an internet cafe with terminals to use. Adjacent to which is the Dream Studio and Pixels Photo Gallery. For getting all your professional imaging captured on board. And then easily selected at all these touchscreen panels. There's lots of other retail therapy to be had at the fun shops, including a Victoria's Secret boutique. Cherry on Top is again along for the ride with a great selection of bulk candies. As well as ice cream sundaes and new ice cream sandwiches. The shopping goes on for days, across two levels in fact. Although unfortunately still smoky, the Horizon Casino's stylish glass enclosed atrium keeps the fumes contained to a degree. And lots of slot machines and table games keep guests otherwise entertained. Downstairs is the main Horizon atrium, with its Carnival Adventures and guest services desks. As well as its own conical LED sculpture, with different dramatic designs on display. And naturally, here there's always friendly crew. One thing that really sets the Horizon apart are its smart elevators, with expedited cars pre-assigned based on destination deck, for altogether quicker service. To attractions like the Sky Ride, a fun self-propelled suspended cycling course, here I am racing my dad on the closest thing to a roller coaster at sea. Especially with its thrilling dips and turns. It really does get the blood pumping, while still being suitable for nearly all passengers. I only recommend lining up early to avoid long queues. Yet another gravity-defying attraction is the Skytrak Ropes Course. For those brave enough to try it without a vehicle. And back at ground level on the inside is the clubhouse, with an oversized take on billiards, as well as table tennis, and foosball. Or outside, there's the sports square and sky greens. Or the likes of mini golf and jogging. And of course, there's a full-size sky court as well. Plus exercise equipment at Sky Fitness. New on the horizon is the Dr. Seuss-themed version of Waterworks. Still featuring all the ways to get soaked and slide on down. But now with even more color. And certainly more character. The two biggest slides are first punctuated by the cat's hat. A half enclosed, half exposed inner tube slide. The second Fun Things one is a fully enclosed body slide. That definitely picks up quite a bit of speed on the way down. The beach pool remains the main place to take a dip on board. Perfectly situated below the dive-in movie screen. And plenty of areas to escape the sun and the shade. The tides pool is a secondary one at the stern. Featuring even more in the way of loungers. Just for adults at the front of the ship is the Serenity Deck. With plenty of its own escapes. As well as hot tubs. Another great option for rest and relaxation is the Cloud 9 Spa. Starting with its relaxation room and thermal suite. Comprised of all sorts of therapeutic chambers. There are traditional treatment rooms as well. In addition to a spinning studio. And full scenic gymnasium. As usual, I only wish this was an observation lounge instead. Rounding out the activities on board are the kids' facilities, including Camp Ocean's Build-A-Bear Workshop at Sea, where children can craft their own stuffed animal friend, or even other art projects. There are play areas set up for all ages. Ramping up to video game consoles. before heading outside for even more equipment and additional interactivity. Specifically showcased as Dr. Seuss Bookville for all sorts of fun branded reading opportunities. And there's Circle C, all for tweens. With their own video areas and dance floor. For kids of all ages, the Warehouse Videocade is just on the other side. And there's quite a wide variety of amusements, including my favorite Pac-Man Smash air hockey. Teens eventually graduate to Club O2. For more play on their way to adulthood. The core of cuisine on the Carnival Horizon can be found at the main dining rooms, the first of which is the Reflection Restaurant. A handsome single-decker venue. The second is the Meridian Restaurant. An even grander two-level space with expansive ceilings to match. Comfort food served here includes tasty dishes like these. Among the many places to grab a drink on board is the Ocean Plaza Bar. With seating both outside of the lanai and inside. Or there's the Shake Spot and Java Blue Cafe for drinks and treats of a different kind. Fresh aboard the Carnival Horizon, Guy's Pig and Anchor Barbecue has expanded as a smokehouse and brewhouse. That means Parable beers are made from scratch right on the ship, and the brewery itself can even be toured. Most importantly though, the delicious beers are available to be sampled. All while taking in the great eclectic atmosphere. While complimentary barbecue is still available for lunch on sea days, premium selections are sold for dinner at a la carte pricing that might honestly fare better as a flat surcharge. Always a popular choice is the Alchemy Bar. Thanks to its pharmacy-themed specialty cocktails. Like the wonderfully flame-finished, fiery tropical passion martini. Fresh rolls and sashimi also return across the way at Banzai Sushi. But all new is the companion Banzai Teppanyaki. for a spectacular dinner and a show. The result of which are mouth-watering courses such as these. The library bar features not only books and games, but also wine vintages conveniently via an automatic dispenser. Also serving wine along with fine cuts of meat is Fahrenheit 555 Steakhouse. This venue in particular has really raised the bar recently with upgraded fare such as Wagyu beef and creative plating, as can be seen here. Another dining option is actually at the Serenity Deck, with salads at Fresh Creations and drinks at the Serenity Bar. Then full side, there's Carnival's signature Red Frog Rum Bar. As well as the Blue Iguana Tequila Bar on the opposite side. For free custom burritos and tacos, there's no beating the Blue Iguana Cantina. Once filled with everything you'd like, you can even top it to your heart's content at the Salsa Bar. From there, only yumminess follows. Remarkably also free is Guy's Burger Joint. Where you'll find the delicious likes of none other than the Pig Patty. Even the Lidl Marketplace Buffet has been updated on the horizon. With much easier to navigate food islands. You can also pour your own beer here. But a favorite of mine was the complimentary homemade gelato. Or my friend here will also make a pie for you for free at Pizzeria del Capitano. With delicious results. the nearby Tides Bar is there to wash it all down with. A premium choice definitely worth the surcharge is the Seafood Shack. We actually liked it so much that we went twice to try a full range of goodies. The Italian specialty restaurant on board is Cucina del Capitano. Serving an array of improved courses. So our all-time favorite specialty restaurant on board is GG Asian Kitchen. Preparing the tastiest food anywhere on board. Of course, entertainment continues to be a hallmark of carnivals, beginning with Piano Bar 88, which can now creatively open to the steakhouse next door to periodically share its live music with diners. Sports aficionados, meanwhile, can head on over to the Skybox Sports Bar to enjoy the big game. There's even a bonus Poker Pro table nestled in here. Cinema lovers will want to head straight for the Carnival Multiplex, however. Where the Thrill Theater is a fun dark ride simulator through this corridor. But the creme de la creme is the IMAX Theater, showing such first-run films as Ready Player One. In the ultimate movie-going format, at sea. The Limelight Lounge is the ship's cabaret. And home to the always hilarious Punchliner Comedy Club. Lastly, the main production shows are hosted in the Liquid Lounge. Seen here during rehearsal before such marvelous main events as these. While the first is an excellent canned review, like most of Carnival's other entertainment, the remaining two delightfully embrace live musicians, including a string trio. The final one in particular goes wonderfully all out with a big band. Thanks for watching. Please feel free to subscribe to our channel, watch our other videos, and visit PopularCruising.com.